Coming up on this week's news, the first guidance on how to connect RCDs and MCBs to the latest amendment of the Wirings Regs is unveiled. A man whose arms exploded during 11,000-volt shock meets the doctors and ambulance crew who saved him, and the householder whose battery storage app let him take control of the power in 60,000 homes across the UK. Welcome back, after the summer break, to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Whether you're listening in the van, on-site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. We hope you've had a great summer and are ready for the long haul to the end of the year. We'll be with you every step of the way. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The first guidance on how to install RCDs and MCBs to the latest amendment of the Wirings Regs has just been unveiled. BEMA released the advice to the electrical trade this week, outlining the new rules in Amendment 3. The technical bulletin explains how to connect both unidirectional and bidirectional protective devices in locations with power sources such as battery packs, solar panels, or vehicle-to-grid enabled electric vehicles. This update aligns with the amendment, which was published on the 31st of July 2024. The Trade Association has also added a safety checklist to help identify non-conforming products. It lists all the new marking requirements for unidirectional and bidirectional devices, so you can check that the kit is kosher. The docs are free to download, and I've popped the links in the show notes. Urgent guidance has also just been published by the Electrical Contractors Association. This time it's about automated electric gates. The reason? Many electricians are not aware of the fact that as the last person to touch the gate, they effectively assume responsibility for the safety of the installation. That's because, under the law, automated gates are classified as machines. So, in the event of any accident or incident, any work undertaken by an electrician will be under intense scrutiny. And if there's any evidence to indicate negligence, the installer will be liable to prosecution. In fact, courts have already handed down big fines relating to automated gate accidents ranging from £10,000 to £550,000. There's also been a case where an installer was given a prison sentence on the grounds of manslaughter. The ECA says any electrician should think carefully before they agree to work on this type of project. The organisation says you should take the necessary specialist training and be aware of the action required to mitigate any risks to safety. At the minimum, it says gates must have a non-contact safety switch, such as a photocell or a laser, as well as pressure edges to stop a gate closing if it encounters a person or object. I'll put the link to the ECA's warning and some advice from the Gate Safe organisation in the show notes. In other news, a Wolverhampton man who suffered horrific burns to his body after touching a high-tension electrical cable has been reunited with the ambulance staff who helped to save his life. In November 2020, Darren Harris received an electric shock in an abandoned building while trying to steal scrap metal. He put his left arm into an 11kV switchboard, which completely melted his forearms down to the bone. He also received burns to his face, arms, chest and abdomen, and spent several months receiving specialist treatment at Queen Elizabeth Hospital in Birmingham. 4 years on, he returned to Stoke Ambulance Hub to meet the crew and the trauma doctor who saved his life. Mr. Harris said he had wanted to say thank you to the paramedics ever since the incident, but the timing hadn't been right. The doctors said it was rare for people to survive such a surge of electricity through the body. Harris says that sharing his story helped him overcome everything and put it to rest in his head. He said the past few years have been very traumatic and very difficult, but he's on the mend and trying to do good things and good deeds. The security of software which allows householders to control their renewable power sources has been called into question this week. It follows the revelation that a customer who purchased a home battery found he was able to switch the power in 60,000 locations across the UK. Ryan Castellucci recently had solar panels and a battery storage system installed at his house just outside London. He intended to set up some scheduled charging, but while configuring the software interface, known as an API, he found he could gain access into the admin account. This gave him control over 200 megawatts of programmable capacity. That's the equivalent of a power station. Castellucci says he could charge or discharge to the grid at will tens of thousands of battery packs. Software engineers say the issue was that the encryption key was just 512 bits, which is considered low by today's standards. Give Energy, the supplier of the battery system, says that it installed a fix within 6 hours of learning of the security breach. It says it actively worked with Castellucci, a security researcher, on the remedy. In a statement, the company said that no organisation is infallible to cybersecurity threats. In a world where risk changes constantly, there is no such thing as 100% secure. Thank goodness Mr. Castellucci decided to use his abilities for good and not for evil. If he'd hacked into Gary's home battery, we'd never have heard the end of it. Building industry chiefs are exploring alternatives to the custom of retention. Current practice is for the main contractor, or sometimes the client, to withhold 5% of a project value for a year to ensure that snagging is completed. But experts say that this sum is typically insufficient to deal with significant defects, and withholding money harms cash flow and investment. Additionally, sometimes contractors go bust during the period, resulting in a permanent loss to subcontractors. Now, the Construction Leadership Council is suggesting a rating system for firms which is based on their quality performance in previous jobs. It's similar to the way you'd rate an Uber driver, but instead it would be a number between 1 and 100. However, in a recent proof of concept trial, the organisation discovered that the industry doesn't like sharing its data on defects. Who knew? However, one of the CLC's partners at the trial, the Get It Right initiative, says it will persevere with the development of an app for assessing contractors. In product news this week, EV Blocks has unveiled a concrete base for DC chargers. Because they're precast, the company's blocks eliminate the need for pouring and curing concrete bases. This allows for quicker installation and reduced downtime. The B800 features a single entry point for ducting and a detachable adapter plate for mounting DC chargers. The company says it provides easy access to cables and hard-to-reach areas during the ducting, cable pulling, and cable dressing phases. Lewden has launched a consumer unit configurator tool. This online platform is designed to help electricians to easily create bespoke consumer units that perfectly match their requirements. You can access it on both the mobile and desktop versions of Lewden's website. There are three main options: the RCBO, dual row RCBO, and dual RCCB consumer unit. At the end of every configuration, you can ask for a quote for either a pre-assembled unit ready for installation or list of individual components for assembly yourself. Each option comes pre-fitted with a 100 amp double pole main switch and a type 2 SPD as standard. For a single row RCBO unit, you can choose between round and rectangular knockouts with options for 5 to 18 usable ways and two colour choices. The drag and drop interface makes it easy to add RCBOs, AFDDs and DIN rail blanks. For dual row units, there are 21 to 39 usable ways in classic white. The dual RCCB unit supports up to 3 high integrity circuits. You can choose between 8 and 17 usable ways and select from a range of MCBs, RCBOs, AFDD RCBOs, RCDs and blanks. When you're finished, you'll get a list of part numbers and product data sheets. The link to the configurator is in the show notes. There's been a big boost this week for the concept of EV charging cables running across the pavement. Milton Keynes City Council is giving the thumbs up to a ducting system from Curbocharge. The council has just completed a trial of the product, which is designed to help householders without driveways to charge their car easily. As it's recess, there's no trip hazard for pedestrians. It follows a similar move by West Berkshire last month. Milton Keynes will now make the Curbocharge duct available to all its residents. Curbocharge says home charging is 5 to 10 times cheaper than public chargers. When a resident wants to charge their car, they insert the cable into the channel and the lid closes behind it like a zip, eliminating any trip hazard. The approval has been welcomed by Curbo investor and TV star Deborah Meaden, who backed the firm on an episode of Dragon's Den. I still think they've missed a trick there, though. They could have called it Curbaretter, like carburetter, because it relates to cars and that's a thing in a car. No? Okay, I'm clearly a little rusty after the holidays. We'll pull it back. And finally, if you've been wondering where Joe 3PO has been hiding out recently, I can reveal that he's been down at the firing range, popping off targets and dunking electrical components into glasses of water. Hopefully he had a pair of marigolds to hand for that. After a few days, he returned to Sideline Studio, wide-eyed and breathless, claiming he had discovered a way to turn a standard downlight into an emergency light. We were disbelieving too until we took a look at his latest video. The link, as you know by now, is in the show notes. Lastly, a reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects, and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. In September, we're shifting our focus to commercial lighting, tools and workwear, and of course, diving into the Safer September campaign that we fully support. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters, along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry, it's SunSync. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home, its environment. Next, they're the brand that pride themselves on keeping people close to what's important. With the world's most recognisable doorbell chime, it's Ring. And do you want a no-fuss lighting solution that's packed with value? Then try the EcoLink range from Signify, combining value for money with top-end Signify quality. Now, a business that will literally bend over backwards to give you the first-class service on the trade-only supply of signal reception and distribution, custom install, home automation and security products for all residential and commercial projects, it's All Trade. If you want to pump up the jam and join the home heating revolution, then it's got to be heat pumps from Daikin. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. With an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart. It's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. The words were adrenaline and apricot. And the winner from the last episode is Andrew Watson 3576. So well done to you, Andrew. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.